Hi everyone, welcome back to this Lightroom CC training course for beginners. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, we're going to discuss the Photoshop interface. Before we get started, I want to point out that this is a training series. If this is the first video that you watched, then check out the description for the link to the playlist with the rest of the videos for this training series. Also, if this is your first time at the Photoshop training channel, then don't forget to click on that subscribe button and the notification bell. Okay, let's get started. Now that we have images to work with, let's look at the Lightroom CC interface. You've seen the import button and the My Photo panel that contains all the photos, albums, and folders. You've seen the Filmstrip. Below the Filmstrip, you have the different options of viewing the photos in it. To select the view, you can click on its corresponding icon or use a keyboard shortcut. When you hover over a button, Lightroom CC gives you a tooltip displaying its name and the keyboard shortcut if it has one. The first view is the photo grid. Then you have the square grid and the detail grid, which is default. You can sort the images by capture date, import date, modify date, and star rating. You can reverse the order of the sort by selecting this option. You can also flag your photos. This lets Lightroom know which photos you would like and which photos you want to reject. The Z key flags a photo as picked, and the X key flags a photo as rejected. You can also give your images a star rating from 0 to 5. You can use the keyboard shortcut to assign a star rating. Simply press a number key between 0 to 5. So, if I press 1 on the keyboard, that gives this photo a 1-star rating, and doing so displays an overlay on screen. I can press 5 on the keyboard to give this photo 5 stars. On the bottom right-hand side of the application frame, we have the different zoom levels. Fit fits the image on screen, so Lightroom will zoom out to reveal the entire image, no matter how large it is. Fill fills the image on screen by its width. If your photo is too tall, you will have to pan up and down to see those areas. One-to-one shows us a 100% view of the image, the actual size. This is the view that you want to work in when you make adjustments in the detail panel, and I'll explain why when we discuss the detail panel. Then we have the Hide Filmstrip button. You can click on it to hide it, or you can press the forward slash key to enable or disable the Filmstrip. This is the same key as the question mark. The Show Original icon is the last in the list. If you tap on this icon, you will disable all adjustments, and you will see the original version of the photo. This is the edited version. The info icon reveals information about your photo. For example, this photo was shot with a mobile device using the Lightroom mobile camera, and GPS was enabled, so you can see exactly where this photo was taken. You can also add keywords or tags to your photo. Keywords help you organize your images. In the top center, you have the search bar, and this is a smart search bar that looks through the visual contents of your photo. I have not tagged or added any keywords to the photos that I have uploaded to Lightroom CC, but if I type a keyword search such as cat, Lightroom CC will return photos it thinks are of cats. Lightroom CC does an excellent job finding photos that match my query, but it's not 100% accurate. It also brought in a photo of a squirrel. But as you can see, Lightroom analyzes the contents of the image, so even if you don't add any keywords to your photos, you can use the search to find the images that you're looking for. Also, keep in mind that Lightroom searches through the album or folder that you have selected. Notice that as I click on the different albums, the label in the search bar changes. You can refine your search by tapping on this icon. You can refine it by star rating, flags, photos or video, keywords, cameras used. These are the different types of cameras that I've used to shoot the photos that have been uploaded to Lightroom, and the location of where my photos were shot. On the top right-hand side, you have a share button. This is how you would save your image as a JPEG after you adjust it. We will discuss exporting photos later in this training video. The cloud icon shows you your cloud storage and the different ways that you can connect into Lightroom. You can click on these links to download the mobile apps or to log into Lightroom Web. By clicking on this link, the browser opens my Lightroom CC web account. You can see the folder we created and the photos we imported. If we had made an adjustment, we would also see them applied to the photos on here. Any adjustments that we applied from the web app will also be reflected in the desktop app. I'm going to close the browser and go back to the Lightroom CC desktop app. Notice that the changes I made in the Lightroom CC web app are reflected in the Lightroom CC desktop app. Finally, on the far right side, you have the editing tools. This is where we will spend most of the time in this training video. In the next video, we will discuss the light and color panels. If this is the first video that you watch, remember that we have a complete series. There's a link to the playlist in the description. Also, if this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button and that notification bell. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again in the next video.